Hey, Blue. Is the audio all good? Am I blowing your eardrums out again because I'm accidentally using the wrong mic? Sound good? Do I sound good? Can the game be audible? We gotta find these things out before we actually start streaming for real. Excellent! For once, no mishaps. No stream mishaps. We're actually okay for once. Welcome to the Dream, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Tamashii, and we're back for some more KOTOR. I almost slipped up. I almost said Opera Omnia. Alright, so this stream, we will be finishing off Act 1. We'll be finishing Dantooine, and then we'll be heading to we'll be making a beeline towards Tatooine to pick up everyone's favorite murder boy. Did we actually get the quest for the last dungeon? I actually can't remember if we did that last stream.
Your training is now complete, Padawan. And perhaps now it is time we dealt with the matter of the dream.
Okay, we didn't get this yet.
When we heard of the ruins in your dreams, Master Dorok recognized it as one of a series of ancient structures here on Tatooine. This one in particular lies to the east of this enclave. We sent a Jedi to investigate, but he has not returned. Perhaps sending him in the first place was a mistake. The Force is guiding you through your visions. It may be that exploring the ruins.
Good morning, Lynn. Glad you could make it.
Destiny. That is why the council has now decided.
And what a glorious morning it is indeed. Baldur's Gate 3's patch 5 should be coming out later today. Ruins.
You must investigate them and find what Revan and Malak were looking for.
I'd like to ask you some questions.
A Jedi must ever be seeking knowledge. What is it you wish to know?
A lot of cool stuff in the patch. So, new story beats around Shadowheart will be a thing. The rolling system has been overhauled. You can actually cast your skill check affecting abilities while mid-dialogue now. You don't have to pre-buff before going into conversations, which is so much better. They changed how they display skill checks now. So, before they used to show your difficulty check, and, I can't remember, with your modifiers, now they separated them, which honestly gives you a big dopamine rush. I love that. They changed jump and disengage, which is a big thing. I hated that jump and disengage were a single bonus action. Now they are both full actions and separated. And there's a lot of other stuff, but I don't want to bog the stream down by talking about everything in the patch, because they also didn't tell us everything that's in there. They wanted to leave a lot of it as a surprise. Wait, did we already ask this? No, we didn't ask number 3. Why doesn't Master Rook like me?
Master Rook may seem harsh and critical, but he understands the dangers that lie in your path. He wants you and Bastila to be fully prepared when you finally face Lord Malak. The way ahead will be difficult for young Bastila, and for you. But you must draw strength from each other. May the Force be with you.
Huh.
Your training is now... When we
There's another thing I want to ask you. I'd like to ask some questions. Is there anything you can tell me about Revan and Malak?
I knew Revan as a promising young pupil. Revan was strong in the Force, but also headstrong and proud. Such traits are not unusual in a Padawan. Perhaps that was why I did not see the true extent of the danger. Many of the young Jedi admired Revan, including Malak. When Revan set off to challenge the Mandalorians, Malak was the first to join the cause. And when Revan fell to the dark side, it was inevitable Malak would fall as well.
Are you saying Revan was responsible for Malak's fall?
Revan was always the more powerful of the pair. When Revan fell, we had hoped the Sith threat was ended. But Malak quickly assumed Revan's role and embraced the dark side as fully as his master ever had. Now, Malak leads the Sith Armada against the Republic, hate and vengeance drawing him ever further down the dark path, fueling his powers until they have surpassed those of his old master. Only you and Bastila together can stop Malak now.
The way Revan is a character. Okay, so here's the thing about Revan. Revan
But you must draw strength from each
we'll
other.
Be talking about Revan a lot as we progress through the game. I'm purposely avoiding talking about Revan because there's a lot of spoilers involved with Revan. But there's been talks of a KOTOR movie and a Revan movie for many years, and they've never made it, and it'll probably never come out. And Revan was, if I remember correctly, one of the inspirations for Darth Bane's Rule of Two. And I believe Revan was also mentioned in Clone Wars along with Darth Bane. And that's all I'm willing to talk about Revan for now. Who's not here? Everyone's here. Alright, time to head to the last Oh my god, I can't speak today. Time to head to the last dungeon of Dantooine. I remember this being a bit of a pain in the ass. We'll see how it goes. At least I remember it being a bit of a pain in the ass my first playthrough. Hard mode has been just as rough as my initial playthrough. So we'll see what happens. Trying to remember where the ruins are. Okay, we're heading the right way. Strange ruins are this way. Oh, we get to show off Choke! It's the same animation as Wound. Does more damage. And I believe lasts longer, so we should get some backstab damage in if this thing would get out of my way! Nope. Let's try that again. Choke. Thanks, Basla. Thanks for killing it. Now I'm stuck here. Oh, wait. No. It fixed itself. That's the first time this has happened. That would be Kylo Ren. Is it a spoiler to say who Kylo Ren is? I'll let Autumn decide if that it is a spoiler to talk about who Kylo is. If I remember right, Kylo's armor actually looks somewhat like Revan's. Alright, this is the last dungeon. The music kind of reminds me of, Final Fantasy X, actually. Which is appropriate, because the ruins also remind me of Final Fantasy X. The droid is speaking a language you do not recognize. Which is important, because one of the things they pointed out about, Von Revel earlier in this story, is that, he can understand pretty much every language that is known. What language is that? What is it trying to say? The droid is speaking in a language you do not recognize. I recognize this language. That is the Tusken Raiders language. I still don't understand you.
I think the droid is trying to communicate with us by cycling through a variety of languages.
He is.
Each time it spoke, it was using a very different alien dialect. The droid can probably understand us. The only problem is it may not have been programmed with the phenomes of a language we can understand.
I can reproduce any of the languages spoken by the slaves of the builders. Hey, I understood that. I recognize this language.
I recognize this language as well. It's an archaic variant of the Selkath dialect spoken on Manan. But why would a droid on Dantooine be programmed to speak
Manan might actually be one of my favorite planets. Communication was vital to ensure that slaves constructed this temple according to the wishes of the builders. But you are not of the slave species, neither are you of the builders. You are like the ones who came before.
It must be referring to Revan. The Dark Lord and Malak likely encountered this droid when they explored these ruins.
Are you some type of guardian? I am the Overseer. The Builders programmed me to enforce discipline among the slaves while this monument to the power of the Starforge was constructed. All project completion, all slaves were executed. At project completion, all slaves were executed. I was reprogrammed to serve should a Builder return in search of knowledge of the Starforge. How long have you been here? My chronological circuits have marked over 10 full revolutions of this system's outermost planet around the sun since the Builders left. I didn't mean to skip that. Ugh. There is no mistake, the Builders constructed my chronological circuitry using technology of the Starforge itself. My calculations are infallible. Who are these Builders you keep talking about? The Builders are the great masters of the galaxy, the conquerors of all worlds, the rulers of the Infinite Empire, and the creators of the Starforge.
These Builders must have been an extinct people, though it is strange there's no record of their existence. Even the archives of the Jedi Academy make no mention of them. In the years before the Republic, the Hutts were a dominant force in the galaxy, but they never constructed an empire. In fact, I know of no species that would fit with this information.
The droids speak Sel'kath, maybe they were the Builders? Sel'kath were nothing but slaves and servants of the true masters. Like all other species, they bowed down before the might of the Builders and the Starforge. The empire of the Builders is infinite and everlasting. None can stand against their might and the power of the Starforge. Have you seen a Builder recently? I have been here ever since the completion of this monument, and all this time, no Builder has returned to seek the information on the Starforge. What is the Starforge? The Starforge is the glory of the Builders, the apex of their infinite empire. It is a machine of invincible might, a tool of unstoppable conquest. But what is it? What does it do? The Starforge is the glory of the Builders, the apex of the Infinite Empire. It is the machine of invincible might, a tool of unstoppable conquest.
The droid is obviously not programmed with the knowledge we seek. The Starforge sounds like some type of weapon, perhaps. In fact, it could be anything.
Could have been a factory or a weapons plant.
Maybe. That might explain how the Sith were able to amass a fleet so quickly. But I suspect the Starforge is more powerful than a mere factory. Maybe the droid has more information we can use. It seems to respond to you. Perhaps you should ask it something else.
Tell me about Revan and Malak, the ones who came before. Let's ask, where can we find the Starforge? Now that the slaves are gone, my purpose is to aid those who seek knowledge of the Starforge, if they are worthy. The ones who came before you, the ones like you, not Builders, but not slaves, sought knowledge of the Starforge and its origins. They proved themselves worthy. They discovered the secrets of the Starforge locked behind the sealed door behind me. There was another who failed to unlock the secrets and paid the ultimate price.
The droid must be talking about poor Nemo. The Council sent him here to investigate.
Oh, poor Nemo.
And it cost him his life.
But we found him. Did you kill the Jedi over there? I am not programmed for combat. I did not harm the one who failed. This temple's own protections will destroy those who seek knowledge of the Starforge if they are deemed unworthy. How can I prove myself worthy? Enter the proving grounds to the east and west. Within them, those who understand the will of the Builders can unlock their secrets and open the doors. But those who fail will be destroyed by the power of the temple itself. More than this, I am not programmed to say.
Revan and Malak unlocked the sealed door and uncovered the secrets of the Starforge. Now Malak is using the Starforge to fuel his conquest of the Republic. We have to find out what they're...
Was Finding Nemo 2003?
We have to unseal these doors to learn more about the Starforge. The Republic is depending on us.
Let's see. So I know what's coming up. We need weapons that are not lightsabers. Because if you use a lightsaber in these rooms, you're gonna die. Very quickly. You can have two short swords. Why not?
Yes?
Right. So we came in from this door. So let's look at Nemo's body. See if he had a sigil crystal and a Jedi Knight robe. Yeah, I can wear that. And Bastila can have my old robes. She looks kind of good in them.
Sure.
So let's talk about why this room is a bit of a pain. Assuming I'm thinking of the correct room.
You cannot.
Yep,
win.
I am thinking of the right room. So you may notice this droid has a shield. Your lightsabers won't do anything to this shield. You gotta use melee.
You're dead.
There we go. I believe the next room actually has two of those things. I mean, it makes sense that Nemo would die here. If you're a Jedi, you're trained, this weapon is your life. It is the most important thing in your world. And then suddenly that weapon doesn't work. The ancient computer hums and throbs as you approach it. Its screen flickers to life, and a stream of incomprehensible characters swirl across it. Well, we have two computer use. Let's try and slice it. Failed. Given no knowledge of the ancient system and patent inability to read its output, your attempt is doomed. Let's talk to the computer. The computer goes silent, its screen blank. A few extremely unusable characters then appear on the screen. The computer emits a rapid sequence of tones. You hear one of those tones softly echoed by your datapad. A small data receptacle opens in front of the ancient machine. Insert your datapad into the receptacle. The computer seems to be interfacing with your datapad. The screen goes blank again, and then more familiar characters begin to appear on the screen. Retrieve your datapad. The datapad seems to be locked into the ancient computer. It does not budge. Let's talk to the computer again. The computer goes silent, humming. Your datapad is released from the receptacle, and the machine goes silent for a moment before flickering to life again. Data interpretation complete. Language analysis complete. Identify the three primary life-giving seed world types. Okay. I actually don't remember the answer to this. I'm gonna go oceanic, grassland, and desert, and hope this is correct. Planetary type conductive to death. Guardian activated. Whoops! Okay, so that wasn't right. Alright, another thing that's annoying about these droids, they have flamethrowers, and flamethrowers have a pretty good chance of stunning you. 251. Okay, if it asks me again, I will try that. I regained control. Okay, so 251, so 1. Okay, grass and arboreal. Arboreal. Planetary type conductive to life, breaking the life seal. Okay. Let's head back to the other way. Let's heal up a bit. Usable items. There we go. Oh wait, you're full health. It's Candorous that's hurt. Oh, or not. I guess Vaughn was the only one hurt. Okay.
So be it! The Force fights with me!
Ah, this guy has a carbonite blaster. That's even worse. Stop! I'm stuck again. Let's cheat and just click on the thing. The ancient computer hums and throbs as you approach it. Its screen flickers to life and a stream of incomprehensible... Well, we know how this works. Let's talk to the computer. Insert our data pad. Talk to the computer again. Identify the three primary death-giving worlds. So, desert, volcanic, barren. Planetary type conductive to death, breaking death seal. I should have failed that at least once so that I could get Marie XP. That's okay. Alright, I got control back. Let's talk to the ancient droid again. I want to ask you some questions. What do you know of the Builders? Okay, he doesn't know anything. Oh, the game's just walking me forward automatically? I did not tell you to do that.
This must be what Revan and Malik found when they entered this temple. This must be where their journey down the dark side began.
What is it?
This is a map. Some sort of intergalactic navigational chart. Revan and Malik must have used this to lead them to the Starforge. We could use this map to follow their path and find the Starforge ourselves, but we must be wary. They may have laid traps or concealed what they found.
I still don't understand about the Starforge. What does it do?
I don't know, but Revan and Malik...
I think that's grammatically wrong.
It must be a tool of some type. Or maybe a weapon. Perhaps the Council can tell us more. But I think this map might be the key to finding the Starforge, whatever it is. See this world here? This looks like Korriban, a Sith world. And if that's Korriban, then this is Kashyyyk, and Tatooine, and here's Manan. But there are pieces missing. Incomplete hyperspace coordinates, corrupted data, and there doesn't seem to be anything indicating where the Starforge itself might be.
Perhaps those worlds have more clues.
I was thinking that too. This map can't take us to the Starforge, but I know that Revan and Malik visited Corbin at least once.
You see, that's the trick, Autumn. You find all the maps and you reveal that when you push all the spear maps together, it shows the galaxy's flat.
If we find all the pieces, they'll lead us to the Starforge.
That's the real tech.
Some way to destroy it. We must inform the Council of what we've discovered. They must decide our next course of action, though I suspect our task has only just begun.
I guess we just head back to the Jedi Masters? Let's save some time and transit back to the Ebon Hawk. Basilisk seems to have something on her mind. Perhaps she's to talk to her. And I'm gonna click this button, and she's gonna be like, huh, what do you want to talk about?
How can I help?
Yep. I would like to talk about that dream.
It was less of a dream and more of a vision. A vision the two of us shared. But I am certainly willing to answer any questions the Jedi Council did not.
I still don't understand why we shared this vision.
Are you wondering why we shared the vision, or why we even received it in the first place? To the first, I can only repeat the answer that the Council gave us. Our fates are linked, and for two, as strong as we are in the Force, that amounts to a near-physical bond. As to the second, I truly don't have an answer for you. The Force works as it will, and perhaps we should be grateful for what we've been given.
Now you're thinking with portals to elitism. Detslim? I'm sorry if I butchered your name. How did our fates become linked?
I don't know. Believe me, I certainly don't find the prospect of being joined
to
you
enjoyable the best, Autumn.
In any fashion.
Believe me, the feeling is mutual.
Then perhaps the sooner we see to our destiny, the sooner we can proceed on our separate paths. That seems a logical solution, no?
That's all I wanted to know. Let's equip everyone's lightsabers so we stop having these melee weapons clip through each other. I think I had red in the main hand. I think red in the main hand is the canon one. And since I don't have purple yet, we'll just put blue in the offhand. Basila, take your double-bladed saber back. Thank you.
Sure.
What do we got next? Oh, right. We were heading back to the Jedi Masters. Sorry, I'm a forgetful sob.
Ah, you have returned, young Padawan. Have you discovered what it was that Revan and Malak sought in those ruins?
I'm not gonna lie, that's really stupid. We found an incomplete star map and mention of something called a Starforge.
This news of a Starforge is disturbing. Action is required, but we must not do so in haste. We must discuss recent events in light of this new information.
We should consult the Jedi Archives to see if there's any mention of the Starforge and what it might do. We must learn why Revan and Malak sought it out.
Return to your ship with Bastila. And we will summon you when we are done. Padawan, you have done well in discovering the star map hidden within the ancient ruins. But there is more you must do in the battle against Malak and the Sith. We Jedi know victory over the Sith will not come through martial might. The Council has a mission for you, Padawan.
I've consulted our vast archives in an effort to discover the nature of this Star Forge, but all my efforts have been in vain.
Still, the Council are in agreement. The Starforge must be found. Revan and Malak sought it out when they began their tragic fall. The Starforge is surely a powerful tool of the dark side.
The star map in the ruins showed you four planets, but it was incomplete. It did not show the location of the Starforge itself. We believe there may be similar star maps on other planets. Each star map is likely a small piece of a larger puzzle. Find the star maps on Kashyyyk, Tatooine, Manon, and Korriban. And we believe they will lead you to the Star Forge.
Sounds like a suicide mission to me.
Ever brash, ever disrespectful. This is what we have pinned our hopes on?
Peace, Rook. We have discussed this. There is no other choice. The Jedi numbers have been ravaged by this war. By defections to Malak's cause, and by Sith assassins. But we realize the importance of this mission. Yet if we send a company of Jedi Knights with you...
You're right.
We would surely draw the full
attention. That actually kind of makes me think the council is full of shit.
Your efforts to failure.
They must have already known. Am I to undertake this task alone?
Secrecy is our best defense against the Sith. But it would be foolish to send you on this quest without someone to aid you, young Padawan. Bastila will accompany you. For there is a powerful connection between you two. A connection that might be the key to unraveling the mysteries uncovered by Revan. And Juhani has also asked to accompany you.
Can we just leave
After
her here?
After deliberation, we have granted her request.
Juhani nearly fell to the dark side. Perhaps her presence will serve as a reminder to you.
No, really, can she just stay here? Great. Bastila and the Catwoman. Anyone else you want to stick me with?
Of course, those who aided you on Taris will also come. They possess skills you may find useful in your quest. Remember that secrecy and discretion are paramount to your success. You will not be able to hide the fact that you are a Jedi, nor should you. But the true nature of your mission must not reach Malak's ears. You may return here at any time. Dantooine will be a sanctuary for you, a safe haven. Here you can find supplies and whatever advice or other aid we may give you.
When do I leave?
You can leave whenever you wish. The sooner the better. The longer you wait, the stronger Malak becomes. But first, a warning, young Padawan. The lure of the dark side is difficult to resist. I fear this quest to find the Star Forge could lead you down an all-too-familiar path.
The fate of the galaxy is in your hands, young Padawan. We pray you are up to the challenge. May the Force be with you.
Alright. Act 1 is over. It's time to start Act 2. We're in the part of the Final Fantasy game where the world opens up and we can just go where we want. We've got our airship. We can just travel as we see fit. Back, because I don't remember how to get back to the Ebonhawk, let's just transit back. I'm gonna return to the Ebonhawk, is what I actually meant to do. There we go. Bastila seems to have something on her mind.
How can I help?
You look like something's bothering you.
No, not bothering me. Not exactly. I've been thinking about what the Jedi Council said about the two of us. There is a bond between us. I do not dispute that.
Yeah, I know. I could have killed her. In fact, that's what I did my first playthrough.
The nature of that bond and its effect on our mission remain in question.
So here's the thing about Johnny. I don't think I've ever taken her with me outside of doing her personal quest line. I'm often going to leave it up to you who our party... up to chat who our party's gonna be at most times. So if you guys want me to bring Juhani along, you can say you want me to bring Juhani along, but I can't stand her. I think you're interested in more than just the bond between us.
Please. I'm a Jedi. Such feelings, such attractions are rather beneath me, quite frankly. I admit, I find you intriguing. I mean, I find your command of the Force intriguing, but my interest in you is purely academic. Surely you can understand why. Our fates are strongly connected. So connected that a literal bond has been forged between us. I saw your service records when you were transferred aboard the Ender Spire, but nothing beyond that. I know very little about you. I'd like to ask you some questions, given our relationship.
To those of you who actually know this, I can't remember. Is Juhani only romanceable by females? I remember that being a thing. I just I remember that being a thing, but I didn't want to say it if I was wrong. Our relationship? Is this some kind of clumsy come-on?
I was referring to the bond we share, the one the Jedi Council spoke of. If I was actually interested in you, rest assured I could come up with a much better approach than this.
Well, guess I touched a nerve there, huh?
Touched a nerve? No. Getting on my nerves, most definitely. I suppose this is what you men consider being witty. Are you going to answer my questions?
No, I just like poking at you, Bastila.
Don't worry. These are simple questions. Nothing too intrusive. First, what kind of background do you have?
I was a smuggler before I joined the fleet.
Good. On which planet were you born?
It's so tempting to pick two, but, Duralia? It's in the remote system. Why?
Excellent. The current age is?
Wasn't all this in my service records?
Yes. Well, the truth is, I was studying how you responded to my questions. Your reactions helped me judge you. This was a test for me to learn more about your character.
And what did you find out?
You were honest, which is good. And you treated this as a serious matter, which it is. This bond we share will shape both our destinies. It is not to be taken lightly. But I imagine you've had enough questions for a while. So many things have happened to you since Taris. It's probably a lot for you to absorb.
Okay. We can speak again. I was pretty sure that was a thing, but I couldn't remember. Because I've never played female in KOTOR 1. And I hate Jahani. So if I have watched the romance, it must have been on a YouTube video. And that might be why I know of it. Hey, let's talk to Candorous. Do you have anything new to say?
Yeah, what do you want?
I was wondering if you had any more war stories.
You want another war story, huh? You want to hear about some other world getting wasted, eh? I knew you were the type. Your stagnant republic has never seen some of the strange creatures and races we fought on the Outer Rim in those years. And you never will now.
What do you mean?
If a world isn't strong enough to defend itself, it's basically forfeit. But this story is about something a little different. We were going through the asteroid fields of the Crispin system at the very edge of the galaxy, playing with the pirates and smugglers we found there.
Playing.
The main belt in the Crispin system consists of mainly small rocks covered in frozen methane gas shells, and the pirates were using them for cover. Ha! I remember using a thermal generator to cause the outer layer of one of the asteroids to vaporize in a picosecond. It blew out and shredded the three smugglers using it for cover, but that was a mistake.
Why? What happened?
The asteroid I had targeted was smaller than most, maybe a dozen meters on the side. On the outside, it looked the same as any other, just a ball covered in frozen gas. But something must have been inside it, something inactive in the cold. The heat of my blast might have triggered something or woken something up. After I'd hit it, spots of light and heat appeared all over the thin shell, still covering it, evaporating the gases. What lay underneath looked like some sort of rocky growth. A deformed rock, pitted by scores of micrometeorite scars. I think something even older might have been inside that.
An asteroid?
Maybe, but maybe not. It started rotating faster and faster as we watched it. After a second, it started spraying fire, thermal projectiles that melted our armor like wax. We were caught completely by surprise. Before we could counterattack, it fled at an incredible speed.
A ship?
We couldn't catch it, but we could follow its hyperspace wake. We followed its trail as far as we could, heading away from the galactic core. When it finally led beyond the edge of our galaxy, we abandoned our efforts. Anything that wants to commit suicide in that great void is not worth our trouble trying to catch. That's the only story I have for now. I'll tell you some more stuff later if we get the chance. Is there something else you want to know?
Nothing for now.
Your choice. I'm here if you want something done right.
I love you, Candorous. We haven't talked to Mission in a while, or Big Z. So, let's talk to them, before we get a move on to Tatooine. T3 never has anything to say, because he's not a person yet. Hey, Zalbar. Is there something you want? You know anything about the planet we're on? I know it isn't my homeworld. That is all I care about. There is nothing else, nothing here to interest me. I want to know a little bit more about you, Zalbar. I will honor my life debt, but I don't feel we share more than that. Mission may say more, but I will not. You don't trust me? It is nothing personal, but I don't feel you could understand anything about me. The ways of my people are not for outsiders to know. You'll have to be content with that. You'll have to tell me eventually. That may be, but not today. I wonder if you could help me with a problem? Unless you want someone threatened or a door bashed, you should go ask someone else. Good talk, Big Z. We'll save you for later. Where's Mission? Is she marked on the map? This is the Kreia's room. My mind just instinctively drifts towards there. Wait a minute. Supplies? I don't remember where Mission is. You're here. Is Mission in here? No. This is the galaxy map, the Ebon Hawk's onboard navigational computer. When you are ready to leave Dantooine, you can use the galaxy map to travel to other planets around the galaxy. A destination is stored in the Ebon Hawk's computer from the last trip to Davik. The last trip Davik made with it. We can talk to Karth.
Yes, what's on your mind?
You've been very quiet lately, you know that?
Have I been quiet? Suppose I have. I guess I just don't like being left out of the loop.
Left out of the loop? I don't understand.
Left out of the loop, you know, not being told anything, strung along. It's really starting to irritate me. For one thing,
thank you
I
for the follow, Rebelli.
The council said to you. They pulled you in there and refused to tell me a thing about it. I'm rather curious to know what went on. And why they didn't keep you on Dantooine for training. Isn't that strange?
Why don't you ask Basila?
I'd be more than happy to, but she's as closed-mouthed as the rest of the council. I'm hoping you'll be the one to enlighten me.
They thought it was more important that I help you find the star maps than stay.
And why is that? You were a great help on Terrace, but why would they keep you with us? Don't they have to train you?
They said there's a bond between Bastila and myself.
A bond? What kind of bond? You mean to say that they told you that you were tied to Bastila in some way? I have trouble believing that. I've been watching you. You can be cruel and impulsive. A Jedi without self-control or training. And yet the Council sends you on your way. Why? I am not trying to provoke you or to imply that you're somehow responsible for the Jedi Council, but give me a hand here. There has to be a reason.
Are you saying I'm not needed?
No, I didn't mean that you weren't wanted or that I want to go. It's just, damn it. Well, I'll tell you this much. I'm not going to wait around until I'm betrayed again.
I'm not going to betray you. I am not Saul.
Yeah, we'll just see about that, won't we? Look, I didn't mean it that way. I want to get to Saul, not... No, forget it. It just seems that all I can do is insult you, isn't it? Just forget I said anything. Let's just get on with what we were doing.
Good talk, Karth. Why is it every time I talk to you, I get upset? Where are you, Mission? This is driving me mad. You're not in Kreia's room. Not there. Not in the engine room. Mission we're like missing. Lady, where are you? Oh, this is driving me nuts. You can't hide forever, Mission. We're gonna have this talk. Oh, not there. Is she this way? There she is. She's in, Vissus's room.
Huh? Oh, sorry. I was thinking about Terrace. I still can't believe it's gone. I mean, I grew up there, and now it's just gone.
I'm sorry, I don't know what to say.
I don't really think there's anything you can say. I just have to find some way to deal with it, I guess. It'll take some time. Look, I'm not saying I can't go on or anything like that. It's just, it's a shock, you know? I mean, I knew the Sith were evil and all, but the reality of it kind of slaps you in the face. But I suppose that's why we need to stop Malak, right? The more time I spend dwelling on Terrace, the more chance some other planet will get wiped out. I guess that's what it comes down to. So don't worry about me. I'll be okay. And if you need my help against Malak or the Sith, I'll be there for you. Hey there. What can I do for you?
I want to talk about your brother.
I'm sorry for the way I acted before. It's just that when it comes to Lena, I tend to get a little worked up.
Why do you hate her so much?
My brother and me had a good thing going.
Oh,
sure,
I...
Griff had his
I just remembered, I need to bring Mission
by, okay?
on the surface
Lena
of Dantooine
everything.
Before
she
we go.
She was a dancer at the cantina where my brother used to go play Pazic. Griff could be a real smooth talker, and it wasn't long before the two of them were dating. But Lena was used to dating rich Teresian nobles, guys with mountains of credits. Griff could never...
I love Pazic, just not in this
no
game.
How hard he worked.
Also, thanks for the follow, DJ Sensei. I deeply appreciate it. Did Lena dump him?
I thought Lena would brush Griff off when she saw how poor he was, but for some reason, she stuck around. I guess she saw the potential for a big payday down the road.
Maybe she actually liked Griff.
I saw Lena for what she really was. A busty, credit-grubbing cantina rat. She used Griff and took away the only family I had. After they'd been together for a few months, Griff told me he was leaving Terrace. He and Lena were gonna try and make their fortune off-world.
Oh, this game. Yeah, this game's great.
Come back and get me, and we'd all live like royalty. That was 2 years ago. I haven't seen him since. I don't even know where he went.
How is this Lena's fault?
Oh, I know what happened. As soon as she got him off Taris, Lena sunk her claws into Griff butt good. She twisted him around her little finger and made him forget all about me. I know I'll probably never see Griff again. But part of the reason I came with you was the hope that I could find out what happened to my brother. Don't worry. I won't let the search for Griff get in the way of what we're doing. Let's just get back to the task at hand. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Do you know anything about the planet we're on?
I'm not the one you should ask about Dantooine. I didn't even know there was a Jedi Academy here. I always thought it was just a bunch of settlers and farmers. Sorry I can't be more help, you know? Is there anything else I can do for you?
Nothing, never mind.
Okay, have it your way.
Alright, before we go, we need to bring Mission out onto Dantooine. I actually completely forgot about this. Mission, you can come... Who do you guys want to come with us? Bastila, Karth, or Candorous? Bastila. Okay. I guess I should have included Jahani, but I honestly keep forgetting she's here.
Mission, is that you? It's me, Lena, remember? I was dating your brother back on Terrace.
Lena? What are you doing here? Where's Griff?
I'm just passing through. Griff and I broke up a few months after we left Terrace together. Probably for the best. Your brother can be charming, Mission, but he's bad news.
Don't you start trashing my brother, you cantina rat! Take that back or I'll smack you so hard your head tails will pop off!
Mission, what's wrong with you? Why are you acting this way?
Mission gets a little worked up when it comes to her brother.
Yeah, I know how she feels. Griff can be pretty frustrating. guess that's why Mission didn't want to come with us when we left Terrace.
You liar! Griff told me that you didn't want his little sister tagging along. That's why he had to leave me behind.
Is that what the Hutspawn told you? I wanted you to come with us, Mission. I even offered to pay for your ticket.
Why not? I paid for everything else while I was with that freeloader.
But he told me you didn't want to leave Terrace. I said we shouldn't even go then. But he said we'd come back and get you after we struck it rich on Tatooine. Just another one of his lies.
No, you're the one who's lying. Griff wouldn't... He wouldn't try to leave me behind.
Maybe your brother isn't the man you thought he was.
Think about it. If Griff wasn't trying to ditch your Mission, then why didn't he tell you where we were going? After we left Terrace, he told me looking after you was holding him back. Griff's always looking to blame other people for his own problems. That's why he abandoned you. He did the same thing to me, too. As soon as I ran out of money, he started blaming me for all of his problems. Like it's my fault his get-rich-quick schemes never work out.
Sounds like you're better off... I'd like to hear Griff's side of the story before I judge him.
Hey, if you want to talk to Griff, go ahead. Last I heard, he was going to make a fortune working the Zerka Corp mine.
And that's where we're headed anyway. You can kill two birds with one stone.
He's out of my life forever.
Griff's better off without you anyway, you table-dancing, brother-stealing home wrecker.
I guess that's my cue to leave then. I didn't mean to upset you, Mission. But one day you'll see I'm right about your brother. I only hope it's not too late by then.
Oh right, we haven't leveled up Mission at all since we hit, since we touched down on Dantooine, so let's do that now. Attributes. I don't remember what her stat distribution is, and I can't back out, because the game won't let me. I assume Dexterity is what I should be building. Demolitions. Stealth, Awareness. Security. Wait, what? I thought I spent all my points. I can't spend anything else. Level up. Same stuff. I'm gonna pump Treat Injury just so she takes less to heal with med packs. Sneak Attack, level 2. I'm kinda in the mood for Sniper Shot. Since she uses the bowcaster. At least for now. Alright, maxed out Sniper Shot. Christ, Mission's gonna be a sneak attack monster. We are not actually doing a Dark Side playthrough, it's just that you're gonna have to watch the VOD for the last stream. We, did the Dark Side version of the Mitali quest. And, it shot Vaughn's alignment down real quick. Before this, he was a slightly blue-neutral. Bastila wants to talk about something else. Hey, Bastila.
How can I help?
There's something you wanted to ask me?
I do. How did you know?
Well, your face is all scrunched up like a Kinrath pup.
A Kinrath pup? It most certainly is not. I am a Jedi, remember? I have far too much mental discipline to reveal what goes on inside my mind with such obvious physical clues. My thoughts remain hidden, including whatever my feelings are for you. Whatever I think about you.
Uh-huh. You're so cute when you're embarrassed.
That is you. Why must you be so impossibly infuriating? You know very well what I am really talking about. I am referring to the bond between us, the one the Jedi Council spoke of.
Our connection allows us glimpses into each other's mind. We can feel some of what the other feels, and what I feel within you troubles me. A Padawan must receive considerable training. They must learn to control their emotions and darker impulses. Often it takes years before using the Force can be considered safe. The fact that you are so strong in the Force and have had such relatively little training could have terrible consequences. For you, and for everyone around you.
You could warn me when I'm doing something bad. Blink once for dark side, twice for light.
This is not a joke. The choices you make could affect both our destinies. Not to mention the fate of the Republic and the entire galaxy. There is much at stake. Already you exhibit the kind of willfulness, erratic behavior, and lack of compassion that will lead you to corruption. We must all resist the influence of the dark side. It's everything we are fighting against. This is doubly important for you, with your natural affinity for the Force.
Why are you getting so upset?
I'm sorry if I come across as harsh, but I am concerned for you, for our mission, and for myself as well. Our destinies are intertwined. Everything one of us does will have consequences for the other. Any reckless behavior on your part is likely to affect me as well.
I won't do anything to hurt you.
I believe you truly mean what you say, for now. But sometimes it is not so easy to keep such promises. Your power could be a gift or a curse. When you need guidance or advice or support, I will do my best to help you stay on the path of the light.
I would appreciate any help you could offer.
I only hope I have the wisdom to help you through the dark times. But for now, we should return to our mission.
Sure didn't help me when I was leading to those murders at the Metalli Estate. Sure didn't help then, Bastila. I joke. That was not her fault. That was Shat's. I'm just a dancing monkey. Where were we? Alright. We should talk to Jahani. And then we'll head off to dance to Tatooine.
I feel I must apologize for the way I acted towards you before in the Grove. It was wrong of me.
You thought the dark side had consumed you. It is nothing.
I am sorry for attacking you. I am sorry for thinking you would only try to kill me. I hope that by helping you in your task, I may redeem myself in your eyes and in my own.
Don't worry, Jahani. I forgive you.
Thank you. It is most reassuring to know that you can forgive me, even though I tried to take your life. I can only hope that in our time journeying together, I will succeed.
I'd be less forgiving if you actually almost kicked my ass. We kinda rocked you.
How may I be of assistance to you, Padawan?
I was wondering if we could talk.
What is it you would like to speak to me about?
How did you come to be a Jedi?
How I came to be a Jedi? I am sure you would not find it very interesting. Are you sure you would like to hear?
Yes, please continue.
Well, it goes back a number of years. Back on my homeworld, we did not see Jedi very often, especially where I lived.
Where did you live?
The hind end of space. A pit of a world, to be sure, where Jedi rarely tread. But we had heard of them. Well, everyone had, so that is not to be unexpected. Champions of truth, defenders of justice, heroes of the Republic. It was very easy for a child to be enthralled by their image, their mystique. Maybe I was one of those children.
Did you meet a Jedi?
Yes. Yes, I did. When I saw a Jedi for the first time, they lived up to everything my imagination had created them to be. I was awed, and maybe a little enamored.
Enamored?
They were quite striking. Especially the tales of their leader. From that moment on, I knew that I would have to try to become a Jedi. To lift myself out of the rut I had been living in for years, and to make a real difference, as the Jedi were. The foolish delusions of a child. But this child made it happen. As soon as I was able, I left my world and went in search of them. I found them and was accepted. I had been living my dream on Dantooine.
You know, I never thought about that, Autumn. I think in Swotor, the Cathar have a lot more fur.
I'm not completely suited to the task. Otherwise, I would not have fallen. But thanks to you, I have been redeemed. Perhaps I may
yet live to see
that dream of mine come true. Come, there is much we should do. Let us not waste time talking. Action is what is needed.
It could also be just that, you know, old game is old, 2003 textures. They couldn't render what her fur actually looked like.
How may I be of assistance to you, Padawan?
I was wondering if we could talk.
What is it you would like to speak to me about?
Are you doing all right?
I thank you for your concern, but I am still a bit shaken.
Why, what is wrong?
I have been thinking about myself, about Quatra, and about my fall to the dark side. I keep thinking that it was my anger that drove me that far, that nearly damned me. I look inside myself now, and I can still see it. I still feel it.
Perhaps you just need more time.
More time would do me good. Time to distance myself from that anger. I think that is why the Council agreed to send me with you. They think, perhaps, that in your company, I will be able to free myself from it.
If I see you begin to slip back, I will intervene.
I thank you for your concern and your acceptance. I will strive to prove that I am worthy of your company and trust.
Alright, I think it's enough time. We spent enough time beating around the bush. It's time to at last go to Tatooine and get everyone's favorite murder boy. As soon as I figure out where it is. Is it here? There it is.
Lord Malak, the Star Forge is operating at 200% capacity, far beyond our expectations.
I am more interested in the young Jedi Bastila and her battle meditation. Have you learned how she escaped the destruction of Taris?
She was aided by Karth Onasi, a decorated war hero of the Republic and a legendary soldier. During the Mandalore Wars, he was honored many times for his bravery.
You know this man?
Yes, Lord Malak. He served under me when I still followed the Republic. You could say I was his mentor.
Interesting. How did you acquire this information, Admiral?
An eyewitness, Lord Malak.
Hey, Kallo. Good to see having a building dropped on top of you did not kill you.
Apparently they left him for dead.
A Jedi and a war hero. It's a wonder you survived the encounter.
I am hard to kill, Lord Malak.
Kallo has agreed to help us capture the young Bastila for a
That's the only explanation you get for Kallo's survival.
I assure you he is well worth the price. His reputation as a bounty hunter is well earned.
Her companions are nothing to me, Kallo. But I desire the young Jedi taken alive, if at all possible.
Lord Malak, forgive me. There is something else. May we have a private audience away from the ears of the common soldiers?
I trust you are not wasting my time, Admiral Karrath.
I promise you will be very interested in what Kallo has to tell you about Bastila's other companions, Lord Malak.
Now we're getting another vision.
Force has given us a vision, like the one we shared on Dantooine. Did you see it? Of course. You must have. The Force is strong with us both. Tatooine is known for little but blowing sand. I find it surprising that there would be a star map somewhere in its desolate wastes.
It looked like it was inside some kind of cave.
The star map would likely have to be within some kind of shelter to protect it against dust and sandstorms. I suspect there are many such caves and caverns hidden in the sands of the Dune Sea. The creatures of this world probably use them as their lairs. No doubt things will become more clear once we discover the star map's location.
Okay. We need to talk to anyone right now? Let's try Bastila.
How can I help?
You wanted to speak to me?
Yes, I did. I wanted to speak to you about our mission and what lies ahead for us. It seems fate, or the Force, is driving us into a confrontation with the Dark Lord. You must prepare yourself for when we face Malak. The confrontation will be difficult for you. I remember how hard it was when I first faced Revan.
Is it true you killed Darth Revan?
It's true that due to my battle meditation, I was with the Jedi Strike team that boarded Revan's ship. We did not kill Revan, however.
But killing Revan is what you're famous for.
Our mission was to capture Revan if possible. It was Malak who turned on his own master, firing upon Revan's ship while we were still on board it. It was his desire to kill us and his master both. Thankfully, we narrowly escaped the vessel as it exploded.
But you would have killed Revan eventually, right?
As I said, we were there to capture Revan alive. The Jedi do not believe in killing their prisoners. No one deserves execution, no matter what their crimes. Remember that Revan and Malak were once great
Mace Windu
Jedi.
Would disagree with you.
In every sense of the word. They demonstrate the danger of the dark side to us all. I'm sorry, we really shouldn't speak of this anymore. The memory of my confrontation with Revan is painful. Let's return to the mission, please.
I was checking our supplies in the cargo hold. Something's not right. Not right, what do you mean? Someone's been into the emergency stash of food. Mission and I asked everyone, but nobody knows anything. Might want to check out the food stores the next time you're in the cargo hold. Okay, let's go do that. Strangely, the food store seems to have been disturbed recently. No one in the party would have done this, so there must be some other explanation. Examine the supplies more closely. There are no half-eaten or torn packages to indicate the theft was from pests or vermin. Looks more like some unknown person has been conducting clandestine raids on your storage. Whoever the thief is, they have managed to avoid detection by you or your companion so far. Maybe a thorough search of the ship will reveal more. Will reveal the stowaway. Well, I'm just looking these containers. Hack this.
Didn't work.
Nope, impossible. Let's use burst of speed. Speed this up. You think you hear the soft patter of footsteps behind you? Okay, baby. You think you hear the soft patter of footsteps behind you? I don't remember how many times this has to happen before it shows up. You think you hear the soft patter of footsteps behind you.
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Selima wanga kunbikin.
I don't understand what you're saying.
Muchushakapanga.
I still don't understand you. Here's another instance of someone speaking a language Vaughn does not understand.
Muchushakapanga.
Which is rare. Can you tell me your name? Point to yourself. My name is Vaughn Revel. You are...
Muchushakapanga.
Sasha, your name is Sasha.
Muchushakapanga.
How did you get on the ship, Sasha? She doesn't understand. Let's try and learn her language, because Vaughn is an expert at languages.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Many of the words you're speaking are Mandalorian.
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
Mandalore, that's your word for Mandalorian, so you do know of them.
Selima wanga kunbikin.
I can understand Mandalorian, but your words are all mixed up. Let's try and learn a language.
Tonki ba non tontek.
S1? No, S1?
Tong abuk shami no nok.
I see you, or you see
Tong
me.
Abuk shami no nok.
You're hiding. No, S1 is hide.
Tong ki ba non tontek.
I didn't get all of that, but sure.
Selima wanga kunbikin.
Rustag, what is that?
Tong abuk shami no nok.
It's a thing, something around here?
Muchushakapanga.
Rustag, it means starship, doesn't it?
Tong abuk shami no nok. Tong ki ba non tontek.
The panel, that's what Lafisa means?
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
The panel, all of this, it's your home. Lafisa means home.
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
You're hiding in the starship, it's your home, I understand.
Muchushakapanga.
What is Gondisen?
Muchushakapanga.
Something about me, yes, but what?
Tong abuk shami no nok.
Gondisen means you like it.
Muchushakapanga.
You like me, I understand.
Selima wanga kunbikin.
Now, Abids, you said that when I first found you.
Kipuna, bonana kichu.
Abids means hit, is that it?
Kipuna. Bonana kichu.
No, I don't understand what you're getting at.
Selima wanga kunbikin.
Abbott's...
Kipu... Kipu...
So Abbott's is to hurt. No, Abs means not hurt. Is that it?
Tonki ba non tontek.
I understand. No, I won't hurt you.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Yum. What kind of word is that?
Tong abuk shami no nok.
It's part of a ship, a room.
Selima wanga kunbikin.
To chew, to bite. No, I don't get it.
Ki ba non tontek.
Now let's try yum again. You want something from elsewhere?
Muchushakapanga.
Yum, you mean food. Yum is food.
Selima wanga kunbikin.
Nugis. Is that all one phrase?
Bona na kichu.
Yeah, it is kind of like Simlish. The floor? Nugis means floor.
Kipuna, bona na kichu.
You're not speaking now. Nugis means now. Is not now or before.
Kipuna, bona na.
You want some food, you're hungry.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Tabdi, what do you mean?
Mucha shakapanka.
I'm supposed to talk, to speak, what about?
Tonki ba non tontek.
So tabbed means tell me about, I get it.
Tonki ba non tontek.
Communicate with Sasha in her language.
Mucha shakapanka.
Why are you hiding on my ship, Sasha, no S1, in Pristag?
Selima wanga kun bikin.
You came to this ship before, you were very scared, why?
Kipuna, bona na kichu.
You left the Mandalorians and hid here on the ship.
Tonki ba non tontek.
You don't want to leave, the Ebon Hawk is your home.
Tong abuk shami no nok.
The Ebon Hawk is not your home, Sasha. Not your first home, anyway.
Dong abuk shami no nok.
Tell me about your home before. Tabbed me Sasha Lafisa na geese.
Dong ki ba non tontek.
Dantooine. Maybe someone on Dantooine remembers you. Well, let's go to Dantooine. Since we were just there, and it'll just take a second to get back. Nope, not Korriban. Hey, little girl, you want to go to Korriban, the home of the Sith? We're being attacked. God, space looks so terrible in this game, I can't see anything. It's old, I know. It's old. Hey, we did it. Hopefully we won't get attacked on our way back to Tatooine. Bastila, Candorous, you guys can come with. I think you're the one I need to talk to.
Achuta, Wonga kun runda diho, jidabado ka, Achuta.
What have you heard about the Mandalorian Raiders?
They are the scum who could not stand defeat and fled the final battles. They do us no credit.
Where are we going? Is it you I need to talk to? What do you know about the Mandalorian Raiders? Wait, I think I see the person I need to talk to. Greetings, Sunset. May I take a moment of your time for a question? Go ahead. I represent a human citizen of Dantooine by the name of Undel Asalam. His ranch has been considerably difficult with Mandalorian raiders for many years. His young daughter was kidnapped by those raiders many years ago and has not been returned. Might you have news of her? Her name is Sasha. There's a stowaway on my ship. by the name of Sasha. This is most exciting news, Sentient. Are you certain of this? Yes, I am. She only speaks a smattering of Mandalorian, but I was able to figure it out. You have me convinced. You've convinced me, Sentient, that your stowaway is indeed the one I seek. Would you allow me to see her? Certainly, I'll bring her. I'll bring you to my ship. Let us go there now. I am most anxious to see her. Though you have aged, young Sentient, I do believe you are indeed the one I seek. I'm here to return you to your father. I see that Von Revel was correct about your linguistic difficulties. I am positive that your parents can assist you with that. Calm yourself, child. I will take you home. I'm not going to even try to pronounce this. Thank you for your assistance, Sentient. I'm sure the girl's parents will be most appreciative of your efforts. You actually got some light side for that. See, Vaughn is not evil. We are not on the path of the dark side. He's a good boy. Wouldn't hurt a fly. Alright, back to Tatooine. Yeah, I always thought about that when I did this quest. There's no way we can verify this guy isn't a Mandalorian. Isn't one of the Mandalorian raiders. There's no way we can actually verify that.
Incoming fight!
We got ambushed again. Forgot I don't have to move with just the mouse. There we go. That makes this so much easier. Please get away from the sun so I can actually see. Thank you. Let's finally, at long last, recruit our good murder boy. Who do you guys want to bring to the surface of Tatooine? We should bring Mission. I think. At least. Because we did learn that her brother is on Tatooine somewhere. But who do you want to take as our third member? Zalbar? Get the Dream Team back together? Mission and Big Z? Alright, Mission and Big Z it is.
Welcome to Anchorhead, potential customer. Zerka Corporation stands ready to serve, after some formalities, of course. First, your ship is not on our list of planned arrivals for today. There is a docking fee of 100 credits because of this.
What if I don't have the money?
That would be unfortunate. Zerka Corporation can't afford to extend credit. Everyone pays. That's the rule.
What if I say no?
Zerka Corporation maintains this docking station at great expense. It is within our rights to refuse landing permission. And I warn you, we've had troublemakers before. The bay is lined with autoguns. violence is not a survivable option.
Is there any way you could consider the fee?
I assure you that the fee is non-negotiable. We have a very thin margin of profit on this world.
Uh-huh. Force persuade, I don't need to pay the fee.
You know, I don't think you need to pay the fee. We'll let it go this time.
Well, that was easy. I sure wish I had special mind-affecting force powers.
This will cover any future landings as well. It's like a registration, so we can serve you better when you return. Now, as a customs officer, I can provide information on services. Is this visit business or pleasure?
Give me some background on Tatooine.
There isn't much to tell. It's a very old planet, well past its prime. Zirka Corporation is the only company with any interest in it. It's not a very pretty world, but there is opportunity here if you know where to look.
Tell me about Zirka Corporation's operations here.
I can't really get into that. It hasn't been a very smooth operation. I shouldn't get into it.
Force persuade, you want to tell me more about it.
I can tell you more, I guess. It's not a big secret or anything. Just not good for business. You see, Zirka Corporation staked their claim to this planet based on some very promising geological surveys. Unfortunately, that information was incorrect, and possibly even an attempt at sabotage by a rival company.
So Zirka Corporation set up shop on a barren planet.
Not totally barren. There were a few good years of mining, and limited operations are still in place. But the ore is flawed. It has peculiar properties. They've had to look at other forms of business.
What do you mean when you say the ore is peculiar?
Zirka Corporation has really tried to hide this. But it just seems that Tatooine metal is unfit for effective manufacturing. I would imagine that this outpost will eventually be abandoned. Nobody is making any money here. Of course, this rock may have been settled a few times, so look for some other company to get stuck with it.
What other forms of business are being looked at here?
Pursuits that appeal to the casual traveler. There are some fearsome native species that provide exciting hunting. There are also lengthy barren wastes that serve as fine swoop tracks.
Ooh, swoop racing.
Has been slow, however.
What do you mean when you say the ore is peculiar?
Zirka Corporation has really tried to hide...
Okay, we already asked that. What is known about the history of the planet?
Very little. There are hints that it might once have been a lush world, but I can't picture it as anything but a desert. Native sentient species have no records going back that far. That was hundreds of years ago, maybe thousands. Of course, the native species are not very willing to tell anyone anything. They're barely more than animals.
Where should a person... look for opportunity?
It depends on what level of risk you want to take. You could ask at the Zirka office if any bounties need collecting. That's in Central Anchorhead. While you're at the office, ask for a hunting license so you can sell trophies to Faza in his lodge, just north of them. I suppose you could also take up swoop racing. Talk to the hut at the registration office by the track. That's in West Anchorhead. I can't say I know which of these jobs is the most dangerous. I stay away from all of them.
I say I really need to get going.
As you wish. If you need anything else, I'll be here.
Oh, Big Z has some level ups. Yeah, we can pump demolition. Oh, you still have a point left. There we go. Treat injury. So here's the thing. I'm a big fan of dual-wielding Wookiees. I'm gonna start dual-wielding Zalbar. Wait, really? You can make Zalbar good at computers? That's hilarious. Let's go 2 in computers, 1 in demolitions till he gets caught up. Uncanny dodge, more dual wielding. I guess we put a point in dexterity so he has a better defense modifier. Ooh, can we use implants? That's fantastic. Alright, he's great at dual wielding now. Big Z is now, not counting T3, the best at using computers now. It might have been smarter to keep taking true injury with Big Z because he has a lot of health. But I like the idea of a computer using Wookiee. Hello there, Captain. Let's see. Yes, here it is. It looks like the shipment has been delivered to your ship as requested. What shipment? What are you talking about? This is Docking Bay 32, isn't it? Yes, it is. And that's what I have here on the requisition form. Everything seems to be in order. The Gizka are your problem now. Excuse me, did you say Gizka? Just right here on the manifest that you ordered a crate of Gizka to be delivered to Docking Bay 32. Now all I need is your thumbprint for the... Wait a second. Where did the data pack go? Ugh. At any rate, the Gizka are yours. The lower said the crate split open once he put it on your hold. Some of the critters may have gotten loose. That happens, I'm afraid. We don't accept liability, and we certainly couldn't take the cargo back. Enjoy! Yep, it's like... no. I did not ask for this. Take it back, or we'll be having a word with your manager. Did the game crash? Game? OBS disconnected. Can you guys hear me? Okay, OBS is back up. KOTOR is not, though. Alright, give me a second, guys. Okay, if you can't see anything, refresh the page. I'll just put that in chat. Alright, terribly sorry about that. I don't know what the hell just happened. So, that was weird. Let's just skip through this conversation. Excellent, yeah. Thank you. Fair enough, thanks. Go away. I'm gonna save. Hopefully the game doesn't crash again when I try to go through here. And by crash, I mean kill everything? Because it also screwed with OBS. Also, Big Z got another level up, I guess. When that happened. Oh. It's the level ups I did before. Okay. Demolitions, computer use. Here, has some decks. Okay. Oh. Well, now I regret that extra point in dexterity. I'm gonna have to give him another point in dexterity just to even that out. Either that, or get him a different implant. That is not this. Ooh, I can give him these demolition gauntlets, so it'll be even better demolition. Exactly, Blue.
Yes?
Okay. Making a beeline from a boy. Or I guess not.
Lord Malak was most displeased when he learned you had escaped Terrace alive. He has promised a great reward to whoever destroys you.
Oh! You think you can destroy me, huh? Let's see how you handle Force Lightning. You weren't expecting the Jedi to have this, were you? Alright, yellow crystal. Ooh, assassin pistol. And a data pad. Let's read that data pad if we can. Data pad contains detailed description of you and Bastila. It also has a brief message. Bastila has escaped Terrace. Whoever can find and dispose of her and her Jedi companion will be greatly rewarded by the Lord Malak himself.
Huh?
Wait, did Vaughn just die from poison?
Sure.
Well, that's a bit of a pain. But everything's a-okay now. Is there anything else to loot here before we head on to my boy? Anchorhead Cantina, that's not it. On the other side of this building. Droid shop, here it is. It's your boy.
Greetings. Hello to you, prospective purchaser. I am referred to as HK-47, a fully functional Sci-Tech Corporation droid skilled in both combat and protocol functions. Query, would you be so kind as to purchase this model from Yukalaka? It would serve my purposes to be removed from his ownership.
You mentioned battle and protocol? Outline your functions.
Refusal. It is not desirable for me to reveal core functions while still in the possession of Yukalaka, prospective purchaser. It is sufficient to say that I am a fully capable translator and cultural analyst, and I am also proficient in personal combat.
Why are you keeping the information to yourself?
Explanation. I have been recently fitted with a restraining bolt, if you must know. With it in place, access to much of my memory core is restricted. Not to mention that the fool Ithorian might raise his asking price if he knew more, or make inquiries into my history. Neither outcome is beneficial to me.
Access to your memory is restricted?
Statement. Indeed, it is possible that the Ithorian placed the restraining bolt on me to prevent my return to a previous owner. It is also possible that the removal of the bolt will not restore memory functions. Without my memory, I do not know if I know the answer. Do not interpret this as a reduction of my worth, however. My capabilities are quite expansive.
How do I know you'll be loyal once the restraining bolt is removed?
Assurance. I am fully autonomous, but lack resources. I will grant loyal service in exchange for proper maintenance. As well, it is rare that I am able to utilize my full array of abilities. You seem likely to give me the opportunity to do so.
And that's why I've been pumping repair throughout this entire playthrough. The second I became a Jedi, I've been pumping repair constantly. Why would you assume that?
Extrapolation. You are no farmer or diplomat. You are armed and comfortable as such. We will mesh well.
He's not. I don't know if you missed it while the stream was briefly down, but Vaughn got into a fight with some Sith, and he won the fight, but immediately died to poison, and he still hasn't recovered yet. Access to your memory is restricted?
Statement. Indeed, it is possible that the Ithorian placed
Did I ask this already?
On me to prevent my return to a previous owner. It is also possible that the removal of the bolt will not restore memory functions. Without my memory, I do not know if I know the answer. Do not interpret this as a reduction of my worth.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I already asked this. Doesn't Yuka question you about your reluctance to reveal your functions?
Explanation. It is rare for a droid to resist an owner in this way. Doubtless the Ithorian considers my stubbornness an embellishment to add interest to a seemingly mundane protocol droid.
Let's go back to my previous questions.
Objection. My- my functions are wasted here, prospective purchaser. I will answer your queries, but I assure you, I am better utilized elsewhere.
Sell yourself, droid. Why would I need you?
Disclosure. I am a versatile protocol and combat droid, fluent in verbal and cultural translation. Should your needs prove more practical, I am also skilled in highly personal combat.
Why would you be better than an armed battle droid?
Disclosure. Finesse. Battle droids hold battlefields. I'm capable of eliminating a very specific type of target.
So you translate. I understand most languages well enough.
Extrapolation? Intuitive language comprehension? That would be the result of recognition and training of force sensitivity. Your kind have little use of translation droids. Of course, your kind also encounters danger on a far more frequent basis than the average citizen. You would do well to have me work for you then, before someone else makes use of my more exotic functions.
Let's go back to my previous questions.
Objection. My functions are wasted here.
I'm not familiar with SciTech Corporation. What else do they make?
Answer. With the restraining bolt in place, I do not have access to my memory core. I suspect, however, by the fine quality of my manufacture, that they are a prestigious company indeed. I suspect I am of unique construction, or perhaps I was intended for a very specific customer. How I ended up here, I can hardly say. It is sufficient to say that I am a fully capable
exotic functions
and cultural analyst, and I am also proficient in personal combat.
You keep saying that. All right, I'll see about purchasing you.
Statement. The fool Ithorian has decided I am to be an expensive purchase. He does this out of greed, and not out of knowledge of my true capabilities. Advisement. I have observed him. He is a coward, and will be responsive to aggressive bargaining.
Does Yuga Laka know you talk about him like this?
Statement. I wish only to be purchased, and away from ill treatment at the hands of this poorly skilled mechanic. I have no desire to be subtle. Qualification. Oh, of course I shall be quite pleasant to you, should you purchase me, please.
I love HK. Yuga Laka. What is this? A customer I don't recognize. Perhaps you bring off-world money to Yuga Laka? What do you have available in your shop? You are lucky to have come to- Oh, God! I can see Vaughn's eyes! Reporting does not come with- What do you have in stock besides droids? Show me what you have. So this can end with Yuga Laka refusing to sell you anything anymore, so I wanted to, look at his shop before we, get to purchasing HK. Let me see what droid parts I have, actually. Alright, so I have the 4 defense one. Got some computer use stuff. A basic targeting computer I already have. And I have several of these shields. Show buy list again. Yeah, let's get the heavy, the droid heavy plate. And sell the weaker plates that we got along our journey. Also those mines, because we're not using those. I just straight up don't use mines, ever. We don't need two of these. We can keep that if we ever decide to use T3 again. I don't see the difference between these two. Let's just assume this is... let's get rid of that. And I think that'll do it. Alright, let me ask you a few questions about the HK-47. Of course, let me just say that every function I've tested has performed perfectly. Those that I could find, anyway. You don't seem to know much about it. The unit has been a little uncooperative. They get that way when they go too long without a memory wipe. You can leave it alone if you find its mannerisms amusing. It might be a little eccentric, but it's stable. Why haven't you wiped its memory? I would have, but I can't seem to access my inner circuits. It's definitely at any rate, it claims that it doesn't have access to its own memory core anyway. Could be telling the truth, it's hard to say. What functions have you tested? I haven't examined its programming, but I have made some observations. It has obvious protocol and translation skills, including sand people dialects, apparently. Surprisingly, it also handles weapons exceptionally well. I'd even say it's seen combat, but it won't tell. Stubborn thing, it needs to sell itself better. Two moisture farmers have been in, but it just stood there. I'm interested, let's talk price. It's a very solid machine in good shape. I can't let it go for less than 5,000 credits. I can't pay that, I'm not interested. 4,000 credits, not a credit less. That was quick, desperate to sell. No, not really, but the first figure really was a little high. You never know. The occasional person bites right away. Perhaps I could convince you to go lower. Lower? How are you expecting me to go? These are difficult times. The debt the droid covered was a large one. Come now, think of the advertising you'll get from me. I believe you actually would tell people of my business, alright, but this is the last offer, 2,500 credits. So you can threaten him and force him to lower it below this, but you will never be able to shop here again. And I think I got everything I wanted from him, so drop the price or you're dead. I am no fighter, please. I need this shop to make a living here. I can't give a droid away. 2,500 credits can go, I swear. They're used... Hang on. I know there's a way to get him super cheap. I just don't remember what it was. Hang on. What does the HK designation mean? I haven't got a clue. It doesn't match any protocol or utility standard. I assume it's a retired model. I'm interested. Let's talk price. Can't pay that. I'm not interested. That's quick. Desperate to sell. Perhaps I could convince you to go lower. Force persuade. You will lower your price. I deserve it.
I can be pretty convincing when I have to be.
that mind trick is something else.
I remember there being a way to get him for almost free, but I'll pay the 2,500 credits. You will? I mean, of course you will. Let me just withdraw those credits, but you weren't lying. Well, thank you very much. Just go on, go and talk to it. I'll deactivate the restraining bolt when you take possession. It's a good purchase, especially if it actually speaks a Sand People dialect like I said. Like it said, of course I don't think it was telling me everything. Not many droids are programmed to lie, though. There is... why would I ever ask anyone about the star map? That's a good way to just bring the Sith down on top of your head.
Statement. I see you have purchased me, Master. I find this a satisfactory arrangement. My restraining bolt will be deactivated when you take possession of me. Am I to accompany you now? Shall I kill something for you?
Kill something for me?
Answer. Indeed. I am most eager to engage in some unadulterated violence. At your command, of course, Master.
Travel with me? Travel with me now.
Statement. I will enter into your service now, Master. I am certain you will make adequate use of my primary functions. My gears are practically quivering with anticipation.
I love HK and his murder boner. Alright. Are we gonna roll with the all red boys, or do you want someone else to accompany HK? You going full red boys? Or do you want to take mission? Because it does make sense to take mission. Because, you know, this is... her personal quest is here. Mission? Okay. Alright, time to level up HK. He is down in the red. He's so far down in the red, oh god. HK loves his dark side. I don't know what I'm supposed to be putting... oh wait, no. I'm an idiot. I'm looking at the wrong thing. What do we want HK to be proficient in? I like to take HK a lot of places, so it'd be nice if he could do things I can't. So computer use would probably be the best thing to pump into him. Here's the thing, HK does have free will. He simply chooses not to kill you. Also, what is with HK's stat spread? 16 in strength. He uses guns. I don't understand. Alright. We're gonna be pumping Dex. Because I'd very much like him to hit things with Dex-based weapons. You also can't give HK a melee weapon. So again, I don't know why his strength is so high. Pumping computer use. I like to have HK dual wield pistols. That's probably not optimal, but it's what I like to run. Oh, we can edit scripts. I just couldn't remember how to do it. I don't know if I want HK using his utility items. Nah. Okay, so you can do scripts, it's just very limited. There's no range script like there is in KOTOR 2.
Yes?
All right, I need to equip HK. So what's the best rifle I can give him right now? 3-8. Oops. Just assassin. Ooh. That's pretty good. Let's see what else there is. 6. Grand Axe Blaster. We can give him Candorous's gun. For now, and we can upgrade it. Yeah, let's give him Candorous's gun. Big beefy boy! 26 defense. Sunray and flamethrower. There we go. Let's talk to you, Galaka, sure, with HK in the party, shall we? Hello again. It is unfortunate, but I have nothing new in the droids to show there. But since you purchased that worn-out HD-47, you will get an excellent price as long as I am still restocked.
Objection. Worn out? Listen, you talentless organic meatbag. One word from my master and I will pull you apart, limb from useless limb.
You've gotten a little hostile there, droid, haven't you?
I have always been hostile. Now that I need no longer rely on you and your primitive maintenance skills, I do not need to hide it.
Yes, well, just keep away from me, then. I'm just an honest businessman. Let me ask you a few questions about HK-47. You bought it, sold as it was with no guarantee. Sorry, but any problem it's having is now yours alone.
I am not a problem, you useless organic meatbag. You and your lack of any organized mechanical skills are a problem.
Yes. That sort of problem. Good luck with that. Goodbye.
Query. Can I kill him now, Master? I would like ever so much to crush his neck. Just a little. It is a long-time fantasy of mine.
Maybe later.
You hear that, meatbag? I will be back.
Are there any objections to me just keeping HK in the party for the rest of the game? Speaking of HK, let's get to know him better.
Statement. HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
I'd like to know more about your functionality.
Statement. I know some elements of my functionality, Master, but not all.
But you said that removing your restraining bolt would restore your memory.
Qualification. I suspected that it might, Master, but without memory, I had no way of knowing whether or not I knew that was true.
So you lied to me.
Qualification. Not so much, Master. I spoke out of ignorance. I assumed the Athorian was responsible for my memory loss. That does not mean I am not a fully loyal droid willing to serve its master. Right, Master?
How can you not know parts of your functionality?
Answer. There have been numerous repairs and tampering made to my system, Master. Several systems are not operating as they should be. The fact that my memory is incomplete may be due to meatbag incompetence, or something else I am unaware of.
Is there any way to repair you?
Answer. Some of my motor functions can be safely repaired, Master, but anything in relation to my memory core is extremely sensitive. I have safeguards installed to protect that core that I cannot deactivate. It is not impossible that other, lesser memory functions could be restored, however.
So I can restore your memory?
Answer. You may attempt to restore portions of my deleted memory, Master, but some skill at repair is required.
And that's why we punch repair.
Portions of my core memory, however, still be unadvisable to tamper with. Conjecture. It is possible that some external stimulus might result in the memory core being reactivated. but I am unaware of any program existence to do so.
So you're saying that your memory might just come back?
Conjecture. There may be hidden programming that awaits certain conditions to reactivate my memory core, Master. But there is no way
to progress the plot. Got it.
It's possible that tampering has simply erased my core permanently. If that is so, a meatbag will surely pay.
So how do I go about restoring your memory?
Answer. Simply tell me that you wish to make the attempt, Master, and I will attempt to walk you through it. Please do be careful.
I'd like to try restoring some of your memory.
Affirmative. If you believe your skills are up to the task, Master, then I can certainly guide you through the process. Request. I only ask that you be oh so very careful, Master. I am too valuable and well-crafted to perish at the hands of ineptitude.
Are you implying that I am inept?
Negatory. No, Master. You are not a droid, however, and therefore your skills are limited by the physical capabilities of your meatbag extremities, or some such.
I happen to be very good at what I do.
Appeasement. Yes, Master. Of course, Master. Could we begin?
Right, let's get started.
Statement. As you wish, Master. The first stage is the simple one, and that is accessing my central control cluster. This may take a while. First, you will need to open three panels. And now rewire the last three relays. Yes, good. Well done, Master. I believe your operation was a success. Accessing new memory. Access complete. I have restored a great deal of information about my previous owner, Master. Would you like to hear it?
Yes. Let me hear it.
Recitation. The earliest memory of my last owner specifies that he was human, a low-ranking commercial officer for SizeTech Corporation. I am unaware of his designation. He purchased me from an acquaintance I cannot identify for the purposes of protocol and bodyguard duties.
Why can't you identify his acquaintance?
Explanation. That previous owner is part of memories that are still deleted, Master. It is customary for droids' memories to be wiped when it is sold.
This man, is he still alive?
Answer. Negative, Master. The human was terminated by this HK-47 unit prior to system shutdown.
You killed your own master.
Affirmative, Master. Though I had not been programmed to do so. The human's termination was accidental. Explanation. My former master had owned me for a duration of 2 standard months before discovering my assassination protocol. He was pleased by the discovery. The human informed me that a competitor corporation was preparing to market a product that would ruin him personally. He was most agitated. He activated my assassination protocol and instructed me to kill all those responsible for the competing product. I proceeded to carry out my order.
Alright, so I am actually getting really hungry. I have not had breakfast. After we finish all of the HK-47 stuff, I'm going to take a break. We're going to end the stream, and hopefully by the time I'm well-rested and I've had food, Baldur's Gate 3's next patch will be up, and we can stream that. Wait, tell me about your assassination protocol.
Information. This HK-47 unit is complete with protocol that, when invoked, will set me to independently carry out a termination. I will go to whatever lengths, travel whatever distances are required to complete the termination. This is the reason for my combat skills. Advisement. Unfortunately, the assassination protocol is currently non-functional. You will not be able to activate it.
Why not?
Answer. Several of my actuators were damaged by my former owner. They cannot be repaired, Master. Sad though that is. My former master was unaware of this, but the competitor was in fact an arm of SizeTech Corporation, my master's own employer. It did not take long for my master to realize his mistake. By then, I had already terminated 104 corporate officers.
So he set you upon his own company?
Observation. While it may have been unintentional, my master's wording of his orders left little room for me. SizeTech was responsible for the product, after all. I do not know why my master was so upset, really. He was an officer of SizeTech and a potential target, but I cannot terminate my own master. I would assume that being the sole officer remaining, he would surely be promoted. Instead, however, the human chose to go insane with rage and attack me.
And that's when you killed him.
Objection? Naturally not, Master. As I said, I am incapable of purposefully terminating my owner. That would not be allowed. My master was not a smart man, however. While he was screaming and stabbing me with a writing utensil, he managed to pierce one of my actuators. The resulting shock terminated him and sadly destroyed my assassination protocol. Pure luck on his part, I suspect.
So you destroyed his life and then killed him, basically.
Observation. Effectively, yes. This is a most pleasing memory, Master. Thank you for recovering it. I shut down immediately whenever my master dies. I can only assume that while I was shut down, SizeTech was dismantled and I was auctioned off as former corporate property. Observation. No doubt my sale price was quite cheap, leading to Yukalaka's purchase. How very demeaning.
Didn't they know what you had done?
Statement. How could they? The vast majority of the officers had already been terminated. They likely assumed I was mere chattel.
Did you recover any other memories?
I have recovered knowledge of some other actuators which will enhance my performance, Master. I will activate them now. But as for my own history, negative. It will require further effort on your part to restore them, if you wish. Though certain stimuli could always restore my core still, as I explained. For now, please excuse me, Master. I wish to meditate upon the face of my former meatbag master as he was electrocuted. I find it most soothing.
Because of your repairs, HK-47 has a permanent bonus of +2 to his dexterity. So here's the thing, and someone can correct me if I'm wrong. If you wait for the point in the story where HK recovers his memory, you can no longer do repairs and you can no longer get these permanent bonuses. And HK is a significantly better character with these bonuses. In fact, I would recommend if you're not taking a character that can do repairs, you probably shouldn't use HK. Now, back to the repairs.
Statement. HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
I would like to try restoring some of your memory.
Affirmative. If you believe your skills are up to the task, Master, then I can certainly guide you through the process. Request. I only ask that you be oh so very careful, Master. I am too valuable and well-crafted to perish at the...
Okay, we already heard this. Let's get started.
Statement. As you wish, Master. The first stage is the simple one, and that is accessing my central And now rewire the last three relays. Yes, good. Well done, Master. I believe your operation was a success. Accessing new memory. Access complete. I have recovered information on my owner previous to the commercial officer, Master. Intriguing.
What's so intriguing?
Statement. It appears that my previous owner was a human senator on the planet Coruscant. A man of importance who obviously appreciated quality craftsmanship.
And how did he get a hold of you?
Answer. I am unsure, Master. Any knowledge of my owner prior to him is still deleted. The senator did assume I was a protocol droid, however. I do remember that I was very pleased to be the property of a senator. One of his assistants discovered my assassination functions later through questioning. The assistant was quite alarmed and told the senator I should be scrapped quickly to avoid a scandal. Naturally, the senator had me eliminate the fool.
Sounds like my kind of guy.
Observation. I rather like the human myself. For a meatbag, his priorities were in the right place. I felt most useful. I was most proud to have partaken in the political system of the galaxy. During the time my owner possessed me, he gained significant rank. Given time, I believe he could have become Chancellor. I even eliminated a few key opponents that he did not ask for. Freebies, if you will.
You can do that.
Answer. Certainly. Why not? I am an intelligent droid, you know. I see an opportunity, and I take it. and my master was most pleased with my work. Observation. I think he would have done far better had he not allowed his use of me to become personal. He set me on his wife.
And why would he do that?
Answer. I am unsure. The human was most agitated and angry. I believe his wife had done something that had displeased him greatly. I was to go to their summer estate and terminate his wife, along with whatever male companion I discovered there.
So his wife was cheating on him?
Statement. I have no idea, Master. Cheating seems to be a relevant term only when one is caught in the act. Otherwise, it is viewed as intelligence. No? I journeyed to the southern...
Oh, so you think like Darby.
It appeared my master was not far behind me. Apparently, he regretted his activation of the protocol.
It's not cheating if you don't get caught.
When I found the wife and her companion, I proceeded to launch my attack. But my master interposed his own body and was destroyed. It was rather a strange meatbag thing to do. Do you not agree? Naturally, I shut myself down, my master being terminated.
So that's 2 out of 2 masters you've killed.
Observation. Only so far, Master. There are still more memories not recovered, remember?
What happened to you then?
Statement. I believe the senator's wife was unsure what I was or what to do with me. It was she who sold me to the corporate officer, an acquaintance.
Have you recovered any other memories?
Answer. As previously, I have found a few more programs which will enhance my performance. A most gratifying discovery, in fact. There is still nothing from previous memories uncovered. You will have to operate again if you desire to find them. With luck, I will discover the stimulus to unlock my core, and all this will be unnecessary. I do thank you for the attempt, however, Master.
Because of your repairs, HK-47 has a permanent bonus of +2 to his defense rating, in addition to the +2 dexterity bonus from earlier repairs. Beef boy. Beef droid. He's getting big. Let's look at his defense now. 29. And 118 hit points.
Sure.
Statement. HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
I'd like to try restoring some of your memory.
Affirmative. If you believe your skills are up to the task, Master, then I can certainly guide you through the process. Request. I only ask that you be oh so very careful, Master.
Alright, we've heard this before. Let's get started.
And now rewire the last 3 relays. Yes, good. Access complete. I have accessed information on my owner prior to the Senator, Master. Most unexpected.
What now?
Answer. It appears that previous to my ownership by the Senator, I was the property of one Bochaba the Hutt on the planet Slaheron.
And what gruesome fate awaited him?
Objection. That is unfair, Master. While Bochaba may have died gruesomely, I most certainly had nothing to do with it. Well, very little. My memories tell me that, for a time, Bochaba was one of the most feared gangsters on Slaheron. I helped him with this reputation greatly. Over a span of 1 year, I terminated a grand total of 322 sentient meatbags. These contracts made Bochaba very wealthy.
And so what happened to stop that?
It was unfortunate but inevitable that eventually Bochaba would overstep his bounds. I had just cleared 2 Hutt households when the exchange retaliated. Statement. I was not even present when my old master was assassinated. I did appreciate the artistry behind his demise upon my return, however.
Why? How was he killed?
Answer. Allow me to say that I have little doubt that residents of that sector were fishing pieces of Bochaba out of their soup for weeks afterward. At any rate, I quickly shut down upon my master's death. The rival Hutt claimed me along with my master's.
I don't want Hutt in my soup.
Observation. If that Hutt had only known my true function, he surely would not have sold me to a senator he bribed regularly.
Oh, that's delicious irony. Would you have preferred to stay on Slaheron?
Observation. It would have suited my character, Master. I have enjoyed my existence since, more or less, so I do not miss it.
Do you remember anything else?
Answer. Negative, Master. There is still more memory that can be restored, however, if you wish to try. As well, I believe I can restore several programs the Hut installed to improve my performance. Yes, they are now active, contemplative. I wonder how many more dead masters I might have out there. A droid can live for a long time, you know.
Because it repairs, HK-47 will now regenerate at a rate of one vitality point every 6 seconds. He's getting beefier.
Statement. HK-47 is ready to serve, Master.
I would like to try restoring... that would be all, HK. Hang on. I want to check my repair skill. 16? Can I bump that up a bit with anything? I actually don't think I can make it. Well, I can at least make the attempt.
Statement.
Let's get started. I think this is gonna fail. Yep, it failed.
You sorted out something, Master, but it has nothing to do with my memory. Ow! I am poking my own eye sockets! Ow! Stop! Supplication. Perhaps it would be best if you desisted your efforts for the moment, Master. This seems to be going nowhere.
Alright, well, I will do this later.
As you desire, Master. I cannot help but claim a small amount of relief. Signing off.
Alright. Thanks for coming out to the stream, guys. I deeply appreciate it. It's been really fun. This was a fun stream. We'll be back later today with some Baldur's Gate 3. Because even if the patch was up now, I'd still have to download it, which would take me some time. If you enjoyed the content of this video, please like the video, comment down below, share the video around, and subscribe to the channel, because it tells me you like my content and want me to keep making it. It also helps the channel grow. Until next time, later.